Hello friends, here we are starting with a new chapter in fluid mechanics. The name of the chapter is pressure and pressure measurement. So let us get started with this new chapter. It is pressure and pressure measurement. Now, when the topic name is pressure and pressure measurement, let us first understand what is pressure. See, when in fluid mechanics we are talking about pressure, it means fluid pressure. So the first heading is fluid pressure at a point. Now, what is the meaning of this term fluid pressure at a point? Suppose we have a large mass of fluid. Here I am drawing the diagram. I am assuming that this fluid is water. Inside this water, if we have a body of any given shape. So there would be a pressure acting on this body. Now, how this pressure would be acting? Suppose if I take a very small area of this body, I'll call this area as dA, that is a small amount of area. Now, over this small amount of area, a small force would be acting. That force I am denoting here, it is denoted by force DF. So now, when a force DF acts on an area DA, that would be called as intensity of pressure. So finally, the fluid pressure at a point, it can be said that it is given by small intensity of pressure, small intensity of pressure, that will be denoted by D suffix P, small intensity, is equal to, it will be given by small amount of force, which is DF, divided by small amount of area, that is DA. So this is the small intensity of pressure which is acting on small area DA. Now if I consider the total area of the body, which is capital A, so the force which would be acting on this body having area capital A would be denoted by capital F. So finally, I'll say that therefore total intensity of pressure, total intensity of pressure, that will be given by, instead of dp, that is small pressure, here I would be having the total pressure denoted by letter p. It will be equal to df, instead of small force acting on small area, here I would be having a larger force acting on the total area, and that total area is denoted by letter a. So here I have the formula of intensity of pressure, and it is given by force upon area. So now we have understood that if there is fluid pressure acting at a point, that would be given by the relation force upon area, and its unit is Newton per meter square or Pascal. This is the unit of intensity of pressure. So from this video, we have understood that what is the meaning of fluid pressure acting at a point, how it is denoted, and what is its unit.